Ahoy there, me hearties, and welcome to the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinkin' Spat Hair. As you can see, we've not been around for a while. We've had a 2-year hiatus, as it were. You know, what we've done, you see, is we've slipped our moorings, and we've weighed anchor and set sail, and dropped anchor now in new digs. So we've got a new harbour, a new riggins, as it were. And once again, I've felt maybe it's time to reinstitute the Poetry Corner and Thinkin' Spat. So, here we go. I thought today we'd start off with the sea song. It's by Thomas Lovell Beddoes. Like fellows, only with a bed. Beddoes, yes. Or like you're out in the meadow, only you've got a cold. Beddoes. At any rate, I thought, you know, we'd start a little simple. So we'll have a little bit of a landlubberly poetry about the sea here on the Poetry Corner. So, here we go. Sea song by Thomas Lovell Beddoes. To sea, the calm is o'er. The wanton water leaps in spurt and rattles down the pebbly shore. The dolphin wheels, the sea cows snort. And that's something, isn't it? Have you ever heard the sea cow a snort? And you know, they're out there. It's a frightening thing. You know, they're so big and really not very graceful either. And I digress. So back to Beddoes. The dolphin wheels, the sea cow snorts, an unseen mermaid's pearly song comes bubbling up the weeds among. Right, so have you ever heard the mermaid song? It's really gorgeous, but the trouble is, you know, if you hear it and you listen too long, you might wind up falling in, and then they grab you and they drag you down to the briny deep of Davy Jones' locker, you know, and that's really not a very good place to be. Sorry, I digress again. Where are we? Yes. Fling broad the sail, dip deep the oar, to sea, the calm is o'er. Right, I don't know what calm he's talking about. You know, you really don't want to be setting out to sail when it's not calm on the sea, you know. It's just kind of like going out in a storm. I suppose, you know, if you're a pirate and you have to cut the anchor cable and head out to avoid a capture, that might be one thing, but you... Well, sorry, I digress. Let's see if he does any better with the second stanza here. To see! All right. He seems to get this thing, he's got this to see. It's like he can't think of anything else to say. You know, it's sort of a strike against him. Maybe we'll have to flog him later. All right, but here we go. To see, our white-winged bark shall billowing cleave... Now, just so you know, a bark in this case, we're not talking about the outside of a tree. You know, that crusty stuff that gets on the outside of a tree. Or you know, the sound of a dog. We're talking about here, a bark is a type of sailing vessel. Right? It's not a huge one. It's not really small either. It's sort of a medium-sized, good for maybe a modest ocean-going vessel. So I'll start the stanza again. But, you know, have that in mind. You know, not so much a tree or dog sounds, but a sailing vessel. Here we go. To see, our white-winged bark shall billowing cleave its watery way, and with its shadow fleet and dark, break the caved Triton's azure day, like mountain eagles soaring light or antelopes on alpine height. Now, why does it have to do that? Here we are, we're out to sea, we're already underway, you know, the wind is blowing, the sails are full, and he takes us back to land. What's he thinking? Go up to the Alps where the antelopes play. What? I don't know what he's thinking, shipmates. I really don't. But let's see if he can redeem himself in the final couplet here. Here we go. The anchor heaves. The ship swings free. Our sails swell full. To sea. I can feel that feeling he's talking about there. I know it well. You know, when the anchor comes free of the sandy bottom of the sea, and the ship, you can feel, oh, suddenly she's adrift, and then the wind comes up, and the sails luff a little bit, and then whoo, they're full, And off she goes. And that's the greatest feeling in the world. And it's just a wonderful feeling to be sailing out on the sea. And it's grand to be back with you here at the Pirate's Poetry Corner and General Thinkin' Sput. And, you know, I think that'll do for today. So, until next time, fair winds to your sails. Keep your weather eye open and your powder dry. And we'll see you next time.